Hi, welcome to this video. We will see here how to use Sony Vegas Pro 13 in a few and easy steps. Leave feedbacks in comments to improve us. Sony Vegas Pro is a professional video editing software to create your own videos and slideshows. When you open it, a new vacant project is opened. In the future, use the new icon on top to open a new one from the start. Let's see the workspace. On top you have the menu bar that lists all the features this software has. A little below, there is the toolbar, very useful for its quick options. On top you can have different windows open. Each window has different options. We will see these during this and the following videos. These windows can be customized. Click on the cross to close them or move them, dragging from the small points on a side. You can open windows closed going to View. At the bottom you have the timeline, where you will work on your video. More at the bottom, other quick important buttons and the player. First of all, you have to import files. You can import three kinds of them: videos, pictures and sound files. All you need to do is to click and drag them on the timeline. Files imported inside are also called clips. These files are welcomed inside rows called tracks. The video tracks contain anything visible, such as video frames, pictures and text. These have a frame icon next to their position number on the left. Then you have the audio tracks. They have anything that can be heard, like music, speech or audio inside video files. These are recognized through a loudspeaker icon on the left. Vegas shows you thumbnails of the pictures and the videos you added to recognize them better. Audio files are shown through their waveforms instead. Stereo audio files have two of them, one for the left channel and one for the right one. Remember that when you import files, you just add a link of them. This means that if you move the source files in another folder or elsewhere, Vegas will lose the link and the file will be shown as media offline. So make sure not to move the source files as long as you work with them. You can zoom in and out the timeline using your mouse wheel. You will always zoom around the playhead. You can also use the bars at the bottom and on the right to move left to right and up down. While you are working with your video, it is very important the preview window. If you have it closed, just go to View and then to Video Preview. This window shows off how your project is at the instant of time where the playhead is. You can move the playhead simply dragging it by holding your click on and moving. It is more comfortable to use the loop region. To create it, simply click and drag on a vacant part of your project or above the timeline. The playhead will snap to it and follows as long as you drag. In this case, the sound is not played. You can also use the player at the bottom of the preview. In particular, if you have created a loop region, the player plays just that region and stops. Moreover, if you press Q or click on the loop playback icon, the player will go on playing that region in loop. Click again to disable the loop. You can play and stop fast using your keyboard. If you use Enter key, you will always go on after stopping. If you use Space key instead, you will always come back to the starting point when you stop playing. On top of the preview, you have different important options. Click on Project Video Properties to set all the properties of your video project, such as aspect ratio and quality. If you want to know how to render in high quality, watch the related video in this guide. Use the second icon to watch the preview in full screen. Then you can also choose the preview quality. Remember that the better the quality is, the slower your PC becomes. Put the right quality you can afford. If you have clips overlapping, it's always shown the clip that stays in the upper track. So the track's order sets the order followed by clips to appear above others. You can change this order by clicking and dragging tracks up or down on the left. Let's see how to work with the clips. You will mainly work using the normal edit tool at the bottom. New in Vegas Pro 13 are all the other tools listed inside the arrow. We will see some of them. You can select a clip clicking on it. Hold the Ctrl down and click to select more of them. If you want to select a huge number of clips, activate the Selection Edit tool at the bottom and click and drag to create a selection area. All the files inside it will be selected. Click elsewhere to undo all selections. You can move a selected clip, dragging it on the left or right in the same track, or in another track that can welcome it. If you have more clips selected, these all will be moved together. Plus, if you move a video clip, you will always move its frames and audio pair together. But if you press U letter from your keyboard, you will separate and make them independent. In case the two parts are in phase no more, they will be both shown in a light red color in the background. You can change the length of a clip, dragging its edges. If the clip has a fixed duration, like a video or a sound file, it will be simply looped over and over. In the instant where a new loop starts, a small gray triangle is shown on top of the clip. In case you want to stretch a clip without looping it over and over, you need to trim it. That means making it longer in time by slowing its playing speed. To do this, simply drag the clip's edges while holding Ctrl down. If you play the clip, it will be shown as slower as the longer it is. On the contrary, if you shorten the clip, it will be played faster. A trimmed clip is recognized through a jagged line between its thumbnails. You can use also the Time Stretch Compress tool for this. You can cut, copy, paste or delete clips right-clicking on them. You can duplicate a clip fast, dragging it while holding Ctrl down. Remember that you can undo any action done pressing Ctrl and Z or clicking on the Undo button in the toolbox. Approach the top side of the visible clips and drag more at the bottom to make it more transparent. In audio clips, this means to adjust its volume instead, measuring dB. The opacity volume level will stay visible under a blue line. Hold Ctrl down to move more carefully. You can also change the opacity just at the beginning or in the end of the clip to make it appear or disappear. This is called a transition fade. Simply approach the top corners of the clip and drag towards it. The longer the fade is, the longer it will last. If you right-click on it and go to fade type, you can change its curve. The curve can change the ways the opacity level evolves to make the clip appear or disappear. Transitions are also created when you approach two clips enough. In this case, you will pass from the first clip to the second one in a smooth way. In audio clips, it's right the same. You can add other amazing transitions in Vegas Pro. Check out the related video to know how to add and manage them. You can split a clip in two, selecting it and pressing the S letter from your keyboard. The clip will be split right where the playhead is. You can also use the new Split Trim tool at the bottom to do this action. If you want to cut parts of a selected clip instead, create a loop region that covers such part, and then right-click and go to Cut. Just what falls inside the loop region will be cut. New in Vegas Pro is the ability to apply a phase shift while you play a clip. Just activate the slip tool and click and drag on a clip. The clip does have two important icons on it, visible if the track is big enough. These are important to apply effects on clips, such as zoom, blur, or vignettes. To see how to apply effects on clips, watch the related video in this guide. As we have seen, clips are inside video and audio tracks. You can create new ones right-clicking on a vacant space and going to Insert Audio or Video Track. To delete one instead, right-click on the track where it is not filled and go to Delete Track. Mind that this will delete any clip inside such track. On the left, you have some options to manage these tracks. Remember that any effect applied on a track will affect all and just its clips inside. So use level to set the right opacity in video tracks. In audio tracks, use the volume bar to adjust its volume, and the panning bar for the balance between the two stereo channels. Make sure that the dB meter never reaches high red volume values, or sound will be distorted. Both kinds of tracks share the mute and the solo buttons. The first one disables the selected track, while the second one disables all the tracks of the same kind except the one selected. A disabled track is, for video tracks, to be invisible, for audio tracks to be muted. When you are done, simply save your project pressing Ctrl and S or clicking on the Save icon above. Vegas Pro projects are saved as .veg, and you can open them later when you need to edit your project again. Thanks for watching this video. Check out the following one to know how to export videos and how to get HD quality on them.